Hi students, in this class we will study the demand function and its determinants. See, whatever happens, there are many factors that affect the particular situation. See, you studying in which school affects what student you are, what is your family background, or what are the funds available with your parents. So these are all the factors that affect the school in which are you. So everything what you do in your life, there are certain factors that affects. So this is the same case in the demand. The demand works because of these certain factors that affect the demand. Determinants, by determinants you means the factors. So what is a demand function? Demand function, it shows the relationship between the demand and its various determinants. Means its various factors. Again, there are two type of demand function. Number one is the individual demand function. Number second, you already know it will be definitely a market demand function. So in individual demand function, the demand is the function of price of a commodity, price of related goods, income, taste and preferences, and expectations. We will understand each one of them in detail. Second is your market demand function. Your market demand function includes all of these: your price of the product, your price of related good, your income, your taste and preferences, your expectations, plus population size and distribution of income. Right? So these are the two factors which have been added in your market demand function. These are the factors that affect your demand: your price of the product, your price of related goods, your income, your taste and preferences and expectations. And these two adds up and make your market demand function. These two are population size and your distribution of income. Let's understand the first factor that affects the demand, which is your price of the commodity. See, in the first video of demand, I gave you a very weird example, I guess, the samosa example, which Indian people love to eat, but I actually do not. So let's again take the example of samosa. At that point of time, we took the example that samosa cost around rupees 5. We used to buy 4 samosas. But when it started costing us rupees 10, we reduced our quantity demanded and we buy only 2 samosas. So this is the price of a commodity. Samosa is your commodity. Rupees 5 and 10 is the price of the commodity. So according to this, when the price increases, your quantity demanded decreases. When your price, let's say your samosas were 5 and then after some time they became of rupees 10, but if let's take the opposite example, they before costed you rupees 10 and after some time they costed you of just rupees 5, so your price got reduced, so your quantity demanded would rise. So this is how the price of a commodity affects your quantity demanded. In first part we read price of the commodity. Now the second factor that influences your demand is price of related good. See, what are your related goods? There are two types of related goods. One is your substitute goods, second is your complementary goods. Let's understand number first, your substitute goods. See, substitute goods are the goods that can be replaced for one another. Let's say tea or coffee, your dispirin, your another headache medicine. So these are the substitute goods. If you are caffeine addicted, you can take tea or coffee. So tea can be replaced by coffee, coffee can be replaced by tea. So substitute goods are the goods that can be replaced for one another. Second one comes up, your complementary goods. Your complementary goods are the goods that complements each other. Means your pen and ink, your Activa and engine. So these are the two goods that complete each other. So that these are the goods that complements each other. Your ink and pen, your laptops and its motherboard. So I hope you have completely understood the difference between the substitute goods and complementary goods. Let's understand the effect of substitute goods and complementary goods on the demand. Let's understand with the example. Let's suppose there is the price of a tea. Price of a tea increases. The demand of the tea will definitely decrease. This you can relate with the example we did in the previous videos. Price of the tea increases, thus reducing the demand of the tea. And ultimately, the consumers will shift to the coffee, ultimately increasing the demand of coffee. See, if you have a tea bag that costs rupees 10, if you have a pouch of coffee that costs rupees 10, and the price of the tea bag increased from 10 to 12, so what will you prefer? As a caffeine addicted person, you will definitely prefer a coffee, because that coffee packet costed you rupees just 10 and the price of the tea has increased to rupees 12. So thus the demand of coffee will increase and the demand of tea will decrease. This is the effect of substitute goods on the demand of the other good with effect to the change in the price of the substitute good. Complementary goods. As I told you, ink and pen are the complementary goods. If the price of the ink is increased, the demand of ink will decrease, thus decreasing the demand of the pen. So there is a same relationship between the demand of the complementary goods and there is inverse relationship between the demand of the substitute goods. If the price of the ink is increased, the demand of ink will decrease and the demand of pen will also decrease. Or the price of ink will increase, this will ultimately affect the price of the prices, increasing the price of the pen and decreasing its demand. This is how substitutes and complementary goods affects your demand. Third one we will study is the income of the consumer. How income of the consumer will affect your demand. I told you before that you should have a purchasing power unwillingness to spend in order to convert your need, desire into demand. Income of the consumer. If your income is increased, you will definitely increase your quantity demanded. You will demand more, you will be able to spend more, so you will be able to demand more. With the increase in the income, the quantity demanded also increases. And with the decrease in the income, your quantity demanded also decreases. The fourth point that affects your demand is your taste and preferences. See, in the earlier stages, if we talk about the metropolitan cities, people used to prefer wearing, girls especially used to prefer wearing suits. But as the westernization and modernization came in Indian society, we started shifting from a taste from suits to the jeans to the western wears. So this is how the demand for one product shifts to the demand of the other product. Let's take an example of suits and jeans. With the taste and preferences, the demand of the suits now in case of girls have reduced, where in the case of western wears it has increased. So this is how the taste and preferences affects your demand. Fifth is your expectations. How your expectations affect the demand. So let's see the in the case of petrol prices. If at the evening government announces that from the midnight the petrol prices will be hiked from ₹73.66 to let's say ₹75.66. So people are expecting the rise of the petrol prices. So in the initial date, in the present, their demand will increase. So you can see the huge lines on the petrol pumps in order to fill their tanks, people are standing. So this is the effect of expectations on the demand. If you expect price will increase in future, you demand less. You demand less in future, you demand more in present. So this is how your expectations affect your demand. In the last topic, we understood the individual demand function. Now here comes the market demand function. These five factors are same. Your price of related good, your income, your taste and preferences, and your expectations. The next we have is population size. See, this is very logical. Higher the population, higher the demand. Higher population, higher demand. If the population of the country is very low, the demand compared to the other countries or other market will be less. Second one comes, the last one that comes into the market demand function is distribution of income. This you've done in your 11th economics that there is inequality of income in India. How the inequality? Lower the demand. Let's take an example of an Audi car or BMW car. People who have a higher income, extremely higher income, are able to afford BMWs or Audis. People who have lower income than the extremely higher ones can afford your Brezas, your different cars. People who are very low cannot afford four vehicles. And people who are below poverty line cannot even afford your two-wheelers. So the demand of BMWs and Audis are limited. So higher the inequality. See, in India there is a lot of inequality among the income. So higher the inequality, lower the demand. So in this video, we have covered the factors that affect the demand.